And seasoned news, we'd ask him to come forward and at least explain to us what occurred and what was the reason behind his behaviour.
The Caucasian man is described as being tanned, in his 20s, and about 175 centimetres tall. He was wearing a grey T-shirt and black jeans. A group responsible for marketing the coast as a business events destination is hosting a sunshine safari for lucrative conference organisers. It's hoped that they'll bring more business to the region after experiencing what our area has to offer.
The Sunshine Coast is well known as a holiday destination, but it's fast becoming a premier business location. Last year, 256,000 business delegates came to the coast, the highest year on record.
After a first visit, these people usually go back and talk to friends and family. So there's a domino effect within the market outside of the business events principle.
Delegates spend up to five times as much as a leisure traveller, amounting to about $60 million a year. Business Events Sunshine Coast formed a plan to lure more business to the region.
We've got 12 of the country's best professional conference organisers, so their role is to really find destinations suitable for their clients' needs.
Most of the organisers manage at least 10 events a year, ranging from 20 to 500 delegates, and so far they're impressed.
To go out into the hinterland here has been absolutely an eye-opener.
Really good. Everything I've seen I didn't really know was even here, so already I feel after one day I have so many things that I can go back and tell people about.
Steve Cooper says there'll be more business opportunities once important infrastructure is completed.
Particularly the Bruce Highway upgrades, the airport expansion and ultimately the establishment of a convention centre at Maroochydore.
Crystal Estelle, 7 News.
Well, you'd have to be impressed. We'll take a break in a moment. The next step towards expanding the Sunshine Coast Airport and new books to help young allergy sufferers.